My dear students, second class, this is for finite element method. Now we will discuss the simplest triangular element. In this case also, we are having the two types of elements. Earlier case, I said about the two dimensional element, two types. One is the triangle element and another one is the rectangular element. And we discuss the its shape functions also. In this simplest element, the triangular element, once again, here, while we are solving the type of problem, certain times we will select a one type of element and certain times we have to consider the another type of element. That is the CST and LST elements. In simplex element, once again, we have to consider that one is the CST and LST elements. What is the CST? That is a constant strain triangular element. LST, linear strain triangular element. Here in CST case, that strain value is the constant always, but in the linear strain triangle, the strain value is varies linearly. That's why it's named as the linear strain triangle element. Here, in which case we will use this constant strain and which case we will use the linear strain triangle? Actually, here constant strain triangle. In the simplest problems, that too, if the given problem is a linear type of problem is there, at that time we will choose the CST type of element. But while you are solving a non-linear type of problem, we will choose the linear strain triangle. Why these two differences are occurred? That is, in linear strain triangle, that is a linear case, the strain value is always constant. Why? Because linear case, if you observe the, that is a displacement is increases with respect to the displacement is increases with respect to the its strain. So that's why automatically the strain value is a constant. Here the displacement is varies linearly. The displacement is varies linearly. If the displacement is varies linearly, automatically that one is a strain value becomes a non-linear. That is a non-linear case is there. In this non-linear case, another name is the quadratic one. That is a quadratic one. Okay, this is the CST element and LST element. Both are triangular elements only. What is the difference? Once again, in the triangular element case, here in this particular triangular element case, if it is a CST is there, just you observe this particular diagram. Here, CST element, here I wrote the CST, constant strain triangle. It consists only three corner nodal points. That is, this triangular element is having a only three primary nodal points only. It does not have more than the three number of points. But in linear strain triangle element, the strain is varies linearly. We are unable to find the strain value exactly. That's why we have to consider the more number of nodal points. Here, if you observe, three primary nodal points are there. 1, 2, 3 at a corner position, and 3 more nodal points are located at mid position of the triangular element, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so here we will consider the total 6 number of nodal points. So based on the problem, what type of problem you are solving? If the given problem is a linear type of problem is there, we will choose preferably CST element only. But if the given problem is a non-linear type of element is there, we will go to the or we will select to the LST element. That LST element, another name is the quadratic triangle. Quadratic triangle. That is here, while you selecting that such type of elements, here, that is your polynomial equations also varies. That is, you know the basic concept. That is, how many number of nodal points are there? Based on the nodal points, we have to choose the polynomial coefficients. If you observe here, in CST case, three nodal points are there, and now we are discussing the 2D element. That is, at each node, 2 degrees of freedom is there. 2 degrees of freedom means it takes the displacement in two directions. So we will express u is equal to a1 plus a2x plus a3y. In the same manner, v is equal to a4 plus a5x plus a6y. But in the case of non-linear case, total 6 number of nodal points, that is the 3 primary nodal points and 3 secondary nodal points are there, or intermediate nodal points are there. Total 6 number of nodal points. That's why, based on our Pascal triangle, we selected the 6 number of polynomial coefficients in one sequence. That is a1 plus a2x plus a3y plus a4x square plus a5xy plus a6y square. In the same manner, in the direction of y direction, in the direction of y, displacement v is equal to, we write this particular equation with the help of 6 number of polynomial coefficients. Okay, do you understand my concept? Here, like that, here we will select the, like that, we will select the either constant strain triangle or linear strain triangle. That is, now we are studying the finite element subject, the theoretical concept. Most of the exams, they will ask the preferably CST element only, rare case only, they will give the questions on LST. So here now we will discuss the only on CST, constant strain triangle element. Okay. Next, we'll move to the another one. That is a derivation of shape function for a 2D linear element related to the vector problem. That is earlier case. Here we discussed the scalar type of problem, but now we will discuss the vector type of problem. Here once again, that is here while we are deriving the shape function equation, there is no difference between the scalar and the vector. Both the cases we will get the same type of functions and the same type of equations and same type of relations, but only for our classification purpose only. Once again, I am deriving this equation. I will go through this equation very fastly, try to understand this particular one. This is, if you observe here, this is a derivation of shape function for a 2D linear element related to vector problems. That is, a linear element means, what is that element? Constant strain triangle. That is, the strain value is always a constant. Okay, now here, coming to the 2D linear strain triangle, it consists only three nodal points in, that is, on xy plane I taken. Here at node 1, its coordinates are the x1, y1, node 2, x2, y2, and node 3, x3, y3. And at node 1, displacement is the delta 1. At node 2, displacement is the delta 2. Node 3, is the displacement is the delta 3. Suppose if you resolve these displacements in two directions, that is x and y directions, its displacements are u1, v1, and at node 2, u2, v2, at node 3, u3, v3. Okay, this is the basic diagram. Now, here, you know the basic relation of stress, that is sigma is equal to E into epsilon, E into epsilon. Stress is directly proportional to the strain value. Here, E is the Young's modulus. Okay, now here, our delta function, delta is equal to, here, the delta we have to write in x direction and y direction also. That's why delta x and delta y is there. That is, the delta x is nothing but a u in x direction. Displacement in y direction is the v. And if you write this u and v at three nodal points, here u1, u2, u3, and v1, v2, v3. Here for our convenience, we can rewrite this one in another manner also. Later I will tell you. That is, here, for a displacement function, u and v linearly varying inside the element. That's why their points, suppose here their values at any point p, if you write with the help of polynomial equation, that is u of x comma y is equal to a1 plus a2x plus a3y. In y direction, v of x comma y is equal to a4 plus a5x plus a6y. Now, applying the nodal displacement, that is here, it's a boundary conditions indirectly. That is at x1 comma y1, that is at node 1, here u is equal to u1 and v is equal to v1. At node 2, x2 comma y2, here u is equal to u2 and v is equal to v2. At node 3, x3 comma y3, displacements are u is equal to u3 and v is equal to v3. Okay, now if you substitute these values, we will get the 6 number of equations. That is u1, u2, u3, and in the same manner v1, v2, v3. But first of all, we will concentrate on the displacement in x direction. Later we will discuss about the y direction. Suppose I will take only x direction equations, the three equations. For my convenience or easy solving purpose, I wrote the three equations in the form of matrices. Okay, U1, U2, U3 and matrix of, that is 1 x1 y1, 1 x2 y2, 1 x3 y3 into the polynomial coefficient, constant coefficients are a1, a2, a3. Okay, here this is the matrix form. These three equations for simplification purpose, I wrote in the form of matrix. There is no difference. Okay, do you understand? These two are the similar. Okay, for easy solving purpose only. Now, our aim is that with the help of these boundary conditions, by substituting in polynomial equation, we have to find the polynomial coefficients. Okay, so that's why here the displacements are u1, u2, u3. Here, these three are the polynomial coefficients. Now, we have to find these polynomial coefficients. Just observe here, polynomial coefficients a1, a2, a3 is there. Here, I bring this entire matrix into the another side. So, that one becomes the in matrix case. Simply, we will write as the inverse. This is the inverse symbol. Next, u1, u2, u3 is there. That is for your understanding purpose. Matrix A is equal to D inverse of D inverse into U. Okay, U is the displacement matrix. D inverse. Now we have to, D is the 1x1 y1, 1x2 y2, 1x3 y3. Now we have to find the D inverse. That is, if you want to find the D inverse, it is a, if it is a 3 by 3 matrix, the simple form is the C transpose into C transpose divided by delta D. C transpose divided by delta D. Okay, C transpose divided by delta D. D mod D, otherwise mod D, mod D. Mod D is equal to 1x1 by 1, 1x2 by 2, 1x3 by 3. If we expand this particular one, 1 into this entire one minus this x1 into y3 minus y2 and plus y1 into x3 minus x2. Here, this entire equation, it represents the two times of its area. Two times of its area. Here, C transpose, that is the cofactor matrix transpose. If you write the cofactor matrix transpose, earlier class also I explained how we will write the cofactor matrix. That's why here I am directly writing this equation. That is a, that cofactor matrix transpose is the x2 y3 minus y3 x2, x3 y1 minus x1 y3 and so on. Like this we will get the D inverse. Here always writing of entire matrix for simplification purpose, I will consider this term as the alpha 1, this term as the alpha 2, this is the alpha 3, this is the beta 1, this is the beta 2, beta 3, gamma 1, this one is the gamma 2, this one is the gamma 3. Same thing I wrote here also. That is here, now I will write the basic polynomial equation a1, a2, a3. If you substitute this D inverse value, here D inverse into U, so D inverse is the 1 by 2a into alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3, gamma 1, gamma 2, gamma 3 into u1, u2, u3. Okay, here this is the matrix is there. Now here u of x comma y is equal to basic first equation. U of x comma y is equal to displacement in x direction is equal to 1xy into a1, a2, a3. Substitute this a1, a2, a3 values here. If you substitute that a1, a2, a3 values, that is 1xy into 1 by 2a into this entire matrix into u1, u2, u3. If you multiply that particular one, now we will get an equation that is alpha 1 plus beta 1x plus gamma 1y by 2a and alpha 2 plus beta 2x plus gamma 2y by 2a, alpha 3 plus beta 3x plus gamma 3y by 2a into u1, u2, u3. That is here, these values now I will consider as the, that is the n1, n2, n3 into u1, u2, u3. n1, n2, n3 into u1, u2, u3. What are the n1, n2, n3? Here n1, n2, n3 are the shape functions. That is for in x direction displacement vector, u x direction, u is equal to n1 u1 plus n2 u2 plus n3 v3, n3 u3. In the same manner, if you derive the equation for y direction displacement, we will get the v is equal to n1 v1 plus n2 v2 plus n3 v3. That is the displacement entire vector delta is equal to uv, that is equal to n1, 0, n2, 0, n3, 0, 0, n1, 0, n2, 0, n3 into u1, v1, u2, v2, u3, v3. That is these two equations for my convenience I wrote in the form of matrix. Why? Because we can easily, with the help of matrices, we can easily solve the problem. So that's why I choose on the matrix method. In the beginning class itself, I said that is whenever the number of equations are there, it is a lot of confusion. But if the matrix method is there, we can easily solve the problem. That's why we choose on the here matrix form. So these two equations I wrote matrix form. Okay, where n1, n2, n3 are the, what are the n1, n2, n3? Shape functions. Okay, we derived shape functions for a simple two-dimensional element. Okay, next here, coming to the next topic, strain displacement relationship matrix. Strain displacement relationship matrix or gradient matrix, and its name is the gradient matrix. Here in last topic, that is the stress, as per Hooke's law, we know that stress is directly proportional to the strain. Now we have to write the strain relation with the help of displacement. So in between the strain and displacement, we will get a one strain displacement relationship matrix or gradient matrix. That one now we have to derive for the 2D element. If you observe the last derivation, the displacement delta of xy is equal to uv, that is equal to n1 0 1 and n2 0 n3 0 0 n1 0 n2 0 n3 u1 v1 u2 v2 u3 v3. That is, if you write that particular term in separate equation, u is equal to this one and v is equal to this one. I think you know the strain. What is the strain? What is the strain? What is the strain? Okay. Change in length by original length in simple form. Okay. That is here the change in displacement in x direction, or change in displacement in y direction, or change in displacement in xy plane. Now we have to consider that is in x direction means it is normal to that particular plane. That is here, if you observe here, that is a change in length by displacement dou u by dou x. I think u is equal to, you know that u is equal to, here what is the u? U is equal to n1 u1, n2 u2, u is equal to n1 u1, n2 u2, n3 u3, v is equal to n1 v1, n2 v2, n3 v3. So epsilon x is equal to dou u by dou x. If we partial differentiate this particular first equation, we will get the dou n1 by dou x u1 plus dou n2 by dou x u2 plus dou n3 by dou x u3. In the same manner, normal strain in y direction, epsilon y is equal to dou v by dou y. Dou n1 by dou y v1 plus dou n2 by dou y v2 plus dou n3 by dou y v3. That is the shear strain in xy plane, gamma xy is equal to dou u by dou y plus dou v by dou x. Okay, why? Because it is taking on the plane. That's why I wrote the dou u by dou y plus dou v by dou x. Suppose if you take the partial differentiation, now we will get the entire equation is the dou n1 by dou y u1 plus dou n2 by dou y u2 plus dou n3 by dou y u3 plus dou n1 by dou x v1 plus dou n2 by dou x v2 plus dou n3 by dou x into v3. Now, if you write these above three equations in the form of matrices, epsilon x, that is the normal strain in x direction, epsilon y, normal strain in y direction, next shear strain on xy plane, gamma xy is equal to, we will write in this particular form, dou n1 by dou x 0, dou n2 by dou x 0, dou n3 by dou x 0, and so on into u1 v1 u2 v2 u3 v3. Now if you expand these particular terms here, I think you know the already in shape functions we derived the shape functions n1 is equal to 1 by 2a alpha 1 plus beta 1x plus gamma 1 y, okay, and n2 is equal to n3 is equal to these two terms are there. If you take the partial differentiation, do n1 by 2x is equal to beta 1 by 2a, do n1 by 2a is equal to gamma 1 by 2a. In this, if you derive the remaining one also, we will get these functions. Now if you substitute all these values, if you substitute all these values in the above equation, that is the strain equation, epsilon x, epsilon y, epsilon gamma xy is equal to 1 by 2a, beta 1 0, beta 2 0, beta 3 0, 0 gamma 1, 0 gamma 2, 0 gamma 3, gamma 1, beta 1, gamma 2, beta 2, gamma 3, beta 3, u1 v1, u2 v2, u3 v3. Okay, that is our strain matrix, epsilon is equal to b into delta. You know that this is the displacement matrix, this is the strain matrix here. Now B it represents the gradient matrix. Gradient matrix. We have to remember this entire matrix. 1 by 2a, beta 1 0, beta 2 0, beta 3 0, 0 gamma 1, 0 gamma 2, 0 gamma 3, gamma 1, beta 1, gamma 2, beta 2, gamma 3, beta 3. Okay. Here, now I will stop my class. Why? Because whenever the length of the my explanation increases, I am unable to upload my class. That's why I will continue in next class. Okay. If you have any doubts, please ask me through WhatsApp. Thank you.